Hello and welcome to another episode. Today, I want to give you another reason to feel hate feelings to me. Because I will explain why you, if you are meat eaters, are irresponsible for world hunger. I can do this in many ways. But the most easy way is that even the Council for Agriculture and Technology, a group in bed with the animal agriculture industry, confirms that America can even feed the whole world. The only thing that is too often, anybody have to be vegan. They can easily feed 10 billion humans, but with only something like 7.5 billion on this moment. Worldwide, something like 45 to 56% of the world's land mass is used for agriculture. Also, according to a research of the World Watch Institute, something like 32.5 billion tons of CO2 is produced by animal agriculture. That is something like 51% of all the world's greenhouse gas emissions. So that's for another topic. But also, at least, conservatives estimate something like 50 to 50% of all the greens, lentils, corn, rice is fed to livestock. Some of you maybe think that grass-fed animals cost less damage to the environment. Think a little bit better. First, cows produce more CO2 in form of methane when they eat grass than when they eat soy. Reason? Because ruminants, in the process that they digest grass, use far more energy. And that's in that process that they make energy out of grass, they produce the amount of methane in their body fluids or body gas. Also, land-based animal agriculture costs lots amount more of land. Simple, because if you put all the animals in one place, you need less place because they are all stacked together in sometimes many layers. On top of that, and most of the time free range means actually that they only have assets to go out of it. They only have to get to see the sun, or can possibly out. Check the regulations on that if you not believe me. So, I've actually talked about two things now a little bit. The first is that land-based agriculture is responsible for 51% of all the greenhouse gas emissions. Lowest estimates that are believable are from the USDA Department of Agriculture, would say greenhouse gas emissions animal agriculture is something like 80% of all the greenhouse gas emissions. That lowest estimate is even more than all the forms of transportation together, which is something like 30%. in your face, you motherfuckers. Well, maybe. Are you mad, YouTube? That I've used that dirty word. Yeah, but I've also talked that I told you now that land-based agriculture is responsible for world hunger, sustaining one meat, dairy, and egg eating culture consumed something like 30% more greenhouse gas emissions, cost from 20 times more food to produce, because the animals eat a lot of food that we eat. Cows, by cows, it is something like 60 to 24% more. 1 pound of a general estimate of cow flesh, or sorry, most people like to call it beef, is something like 1 pound of beef cost to produce something like 60 pounds of wheat. But it all go up to something like 24% for a pound of wheat for 1 pound of flesh of our other animals, of cows. One general estimate is that it costs something like, I don't know, 5 to 27 times the amount of plant products to produce 1 pound of meat product or animal meat products. It is also worth noticing that the America population, the most wasteful culture of this whole planet, consumed 20% of all the animals killed for flesh. They're only being something like 5% of the human population. You don't have to be Einstein to figure out the conclusion that animal agriculture, in all of its ways, are inferior to the produce in a sane system, not a system that supports animal slavery and subsidizes this kind of horrible satanistic rituals, in my words, but also in the words of the victims I suggest. The animals are killed in many ways. One of the reasons is that they're being hung upside down and somebody cuts their throat. That's the most common practice. Second, they're put the animals into electro bands and execute them. Gassing is the most humane way of killing or executing innocent animals. Even I will nothing suggest this kind of ways of taking the life of some other living being as anything would even come close to humane. Humane means that you also don't care if somebody do it to you. It means, actually, if you are a sane person, if you not want somebody murder you or take you flesh for no other reason than for one misplaced fetish, that's also being rational that you don't pay somebody else to do that to other living beings. Understand? Since no one in this whole world needs animal products to survive, it's more logical to go vegan and help to stop world hunger. Any 2 seconds, a child starves from starvation. The animals get fat all the times because of all the greens and all the lentils that we feed to livestock. Another quick fact. Be you aware that something like 65% of the rainforest is cut for cattle ranching, and another 10 to 20, according to a combination of studies, I will put them in the description below if I can find them back. Is a smoke-based agriculture, and also another 10 to 20% is land-based agriculture. It's also the large scale and small scale is that. Something like 20% above is, if you take a combination of the studies. Logging is only 1 to 3% according to the studies. Flat island analysis of the studies I've read about it. And the resources and for human buildings, that's something like 2 to 5%. It's safe to assume that that animal agriculture is responsible for something like 91% of all the deforestation. It's safely to assume. And to say. So, while focusing on logging, what are a small percent of our legal processing from some business? When the big baddie of deforestation is any day on your dinner plate. If you give about rainforest, you have to be vegan. If you give about people dying from starvation, you must have to go vegan. And if you giving about global warming and you want to reduce your footprint on the earth, your eco footprint, you must go vegan. On vegan, riding a hammer costs even a lesser stroke on the earth, or pass to the earth, than a meat eater riding a bicycle. Humans have the bad habit to focus on 1% of a problem. I know it. That's the reason that we also have a self-destructed species. You can't start with focusing on the whole spectrum of suffering. I say always, it don't matter that you have made a mistake, but go on. Apologize for the way you are living. For one moment, for one chance. Put that ego away. That ego of you is a problem that you make the same mistakes over and over again. The ego of humans is that they think they can choose to be kind to one and violate the rights of others. Say, slavery is bad. Exploitation of black people is bad. But say, I've been for speciesism. Or say, you mean for exploitation of gay people and not allow them to marriage. That's the ascension of evil. Knowing better, but not choosing to act better. I live not in a fantasy land, also that you know that. And now there have been also other problems besides veganism that needs attention. But veganism must be the core. Because if we not attack this specific thing, all the other things are meaningless. I'm not saying it games. I have not the right to marriage. So don't hold me out of context. Don't affect anything in a bad way. If gay people can marriage. That is absurdity. If somebody say, as gay people marry, so then our stupid patriarchy will break down. Or something like that. Or if women get rights, I will dominate the world. It's like some stupid man rights people say. The system has nothing suffered and will nothing suffer from giving victims their rights. Yet. Always the majority always fights to improvements of the society. Take 400 years. So let the majority of white people stop viewing black people as inanimate things that I can play with and molest and do other disgusting things too. Like slave, sell their children. Just like people do with other animals. The root of all discrimination and all hatred is speciesism. If a child grow up and see a chicken or a pig and the parents teach them that even the chicken and the pig and etc. are seems different to them, act maybe a bit different than them, or the dog, cat of their household. And if you do that from a young age and you teach them actually compassion instead of distortion. So that's what people always do. Kill that turkey for Thanksgiving. Kill that the rats. But say, be nice to the dog, be nice to the cat. Being kind to rhinos. Stay away from pigs because they can be angry and kill them because they're fooled. So you're not, you confuse the kid if you do that. You have to be constant if it comes to moral questions. And morality is not something that you can say, this is not morality and that's not morality. Morality is actually based on the everyday phenomena of compassion without any alternative consideration, wherein the compassionate person feel no different from the suffering person of animal that is seen. Even the suffering person is one in external being, I feel connected to this person before me. And for a moment, the area between the ego and the non-ego is for one moment abolished. And therefore, the compassionate person is no egocentric because he feels no difference than the suffering person. He has interiorized himself with the suffering subject. And therefore, he's free from any immorality. I consider, therefore, that compassion is the only pure form of moral conduct. And other motive coming from any of the other essence of homini actions have no moral value. That being malice and ego, that be not a way. Malice, ego, and compassion. Malice is what people will think that they have the right to exploit them. Ego is the will to get things for themselves, and in combination with malice, leads this to great immorality. Just like the short handle to corruption. People, you must see this through the eyes of the victims. This is pretty easy to put stuff all away. Say that it is stupid. Say that it's not real. It's an illusion. That the studies I present are lying and distorting the truth. It's pretty easy if you are the victimizer. If you are in the position of the oppressor, if you are in the position of the elitist, understand you? If you are not a victim, don't imagine it entirely from your point of view. Because if you are not the victim, it becomes pretty easy to mock your victims, make fun of their entire existence, label them stupid and dirty. But when you are a victim, think a lot different from that angle. And I want to try to learn people to take the blinders away and see anything from one real perception, not from one condition perception of the media. Peace begins on the dinner table. By what you eat on a daily basis. How can you ask for something you are not willing to give? Compassion, decency, respect. When you're not even being willing to give even the little bits, even the smallest thing up. What a sick, ridiculous puppets we are. Dancing, fuck, not caring the world, not knowing we are nothing. We are not what was intended. When darkness and light become one, the reality splitter away, and the truth become visible.